Hi, I'm Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in managerial accounting. And in this video, we're going to discuss variable overhead analysis. We'll start off by going through the meaning of variable overhead. Next, we'll discuss how variance analysis can be used to evaluate a company's ability to manage their variable overhead costs by looking at a specific example, breaking this down further into both spending and efficiency variances. Understanding this concept can help companies manage their resources more efficiently and make smarter long-term business decisions. So let's get started. Overhead can be a significant expense on a company's income statement. Companies typically spend a large amount of money each period on these indirect costs that are not directly linked to creating each individual product or service. Some examples are things like rent, utilities, insurance, or administrative costs. A company's ability to manage and control these costs helps to ensure the company is profitable and the margins are strong. In order to plan for future operations and control spending, most companies produce overhead budgets, which they can then use as a tool to evaluate how effective they were at managing both the spending and efficiency of their overhead. In this video, we're going to be focusing on variable overhead variances. But what do we mean when we say variable? There's two key categories of overhead costs: fixed overhead and variable overhead. Fixed overhead costs don't change based on the level of activity. Examples of fixed overhead are things like rent, salaries, depreciation, and insurance. Variable overhead, on the other hand, are costs that fluctuate based on the level of activity. Generally speaking, total variable overhead costs will increase when the activity level increases and decrease when the activity level decreases. Common examples of variable overhead costs include indirect materials, supplies, and indirect labor. For example, let's say a company spends $10 per unit of production on maintenance. If they produce one unit, they'll spend $10 on maintenance. However, if they produce 10 units, they'll spend $100 on maintenance. In order to manage these overhead costs effectively, companies will use variance analysis as a tool. The starting point for a variable overhead variance analysis will be to calculate the total variable overhead variance. This variance tells management of the company the difference between what they actually spent on variable overhead and what they should have spent based on the plan. This is calculated with the formula actual variable overhead minus applied variable overhead equals total variable overhead. Once this variance is calculated, it can be further broken down into spending and efficiency variances to determine the driver for the difference. Let's look at a brief example. On your screen, you're seeing some information related to the variable overhead costs for a manufacturing company. Using this information, we can calculate the total variable overhead variance in three quick steps. Step one will be to calculate the standard direct labor hours for actual production. This will tell the company how many hours they should have spent on their actual production based on their original budgeted expectations. In this example, they budgeted to spend 0.15 hours on every unit they produced. If we look at the actual production, we see that they produced 1,000 units. So to determine the standard direct labor hours for actual production, all we have to do is take the standard hours allowed per unit of 0.15 hours and multiply this by the actual units produced of 1,000 units for a result of 150 direct labor hours. This is the total number of hours the company should have spent on the actual level of production. Step two will be to calculate the applied overhead, and then we'll compute the total variable overhead variance. The formula for this will be the actual variable overhead minus the applied variable overhead will give us the total variable overhead variance. From the image, we know that the actual amount that the company spent on variable overhead this period was $1,200. To calculate the applied variable overhead, which is the amount of overhead the company would have expected to spend based on their budget, we would take the total standard direct labor hours, which we just calculated from step one of 150 hours, and multiply this by the standard variable overhead rate of $10 per hour. As a final step, we'll take the difference between the actual variable overhead of $1,200 and the applied variable overhead of $1,500, which equals $300. Since the company spent $300 less than they planned, in this case, they would have a favorable variance. Anytime a variance is identified, it's important that the company determine whether this is favorable or unfavorable so that they make a decision on how to proceed. When calculating overhead variances, it's a common mistake to mix up the determination on whether the variance is favorable or unfavorable for the company. In the example we just looked at, when we took the actual variable overhead of $1,200 and subtracted the applied variable overhead of $1,500, this results in a negative $300 amount. Now, while it may be tempting to think this is an unfavorable variance, since it's a negative number, in the case of overhead variances, since they spent less than they planned, this is actually a positive result, and they would therefore have a favorable variance. Now, even though this was a favorable variance, the company may want to investigate further to find out the root cause. To do this, we would break down the $300 variance further into both spending and efficiency variances. Let's calculate the variable overhead spending variance first. This will be done by taking the actual variable overhead less the actual hours multiplied by the standard variable overhead rate. Variable overhead spending variance is the difference between the actual variable overhead costs and the expected amount that should have been spent based on the actual hours worked. The actual variable overhead is given to us here, which is $1,200. We need to find the difference between this and the actual hours of 200 times the standard variable overhead rate of $10, which equals $2,000. If we take the difference between the $1,200 that the company actually spent and the $2,000 that they should have spent, we see we have a difference of $800. Since they spent less than they planned, this would be a favorable spending variance. Next, we calculate the variable overhead efficiency variance, which is the difference between actual variable overhead and standard variable overhead based on the time that was budgeted for it. The calculation for this is actual hours minus standard hours times the standard variable overhead rate. If we take the difference between the actual hours of 200 and the standard hours that we calculated earlier in the video of 150, that results in a difference of 50 hours. We would then multiply the 50 hours by the standard variable overhead rate of $10, giving us a result of $500. Now, is this a favorable or unfavorable variance from an efficiency perspective? Well, since the company planned to take 150 hours and actually took 200 hours to complete the work, this would be considered a $500 unfavorable variance when it comes to efficiency. This means they likely did not manage their labor as well as they would have liked, spending longer than planned to produce their products. As we can see here, when we sum up the two variances that we just discussed, this brings us back to our original total variance of $300 favorable. Here we can see that even though the company had a favorable outcome, they could do even better in the future by spending more time investigating ways to improve their unfavorable efficiency variance, such as training their labor force to complete tasks in a more time-efficient manner. And that brings us to the end of this video. Variable overhead variance analysis is an extremely important tool that companies can use to manage and improve their profitability. It allows organizations to pinpoint areas that are going well in the company, while also narrowing in on areas requiring improvement going forward. If you're interested in learning more about this topic or others, please feel free to check out our additional videos on many more related topics.